welcome to the hottest music from around the planet on Countdown. Tonight, a new one for Hall & Oates. Plus, it's Up, Up & Away with Nina and Countdown-bound Billy Idol yells across the country. Now, the Soldier of Fortune takes part in War Games. The new record for John Paul Young.
What to do Saturday night in the heart of America is beating like a time bomb, ready to explode. In this Union town, the hammer comes down and echoes in my ears, and life becomes so predictable and far too real. So good night, America. Good night, America. Good night, good night. They're playing war games in the video arcade. They're playing war games in the video arcade. They're playing war games in the video arcade. And push your imagination. The combat zone, the wind in your hair, a helicopter blade is chanting like a choir boy in the jungle. So good night, America. Good night, good night. Good night, America. Good night, good night. They're playing war games in the video arcade. They're playing war games in the video arcade. They're playing war games in the video arcade. War games in the video arcade.
From the war zone to the Countdown studio, John Paul Young is your special guest host, along with the number one pin-up girl on the wall, Jane Clifton.
Hi.
Hello. Welcome to Countdown. Hell in those trenches, man.
Oh, shocking business.
Terrible.
You're all ripped too.
Yep.
Dreadful.
Murderous. China crisis, which brings us to another war. China crisis, who are very big in England, and they've been supporting Simple Minds around the place.
And they're rumoured to be touring Australia later in this year, in June, in fact, as a support to Simple Minds.
Yes, and here is their new single, or their latest single, Working with Fire and Steel, China Crisis.
Paradise, but a good island, high office, and something that got old.
China Quiet Crisis and still to come Berlin's Nina and San Francisco's Huey Lewis. Now from Long Island, New York, a new name in the industry. It's Industry with State of the Nation.
Have to fight. there's no place like home.
There's no place like home. And that was Industry with State of the Nation.
And speaking of which, Nina, 99-ish Luftballons, what does it all mean? John's been to Germany. He's told me that 99-ish Luftballons was inspired by the balloons let off at the end of the Rolling Stones concert in Berlin. And Carlo, the guitarist in the band, wondered what would happen if the balloons drifted over the Berlin Wall into East Berlin.
They'd go red.
They'd go red and they'd start having hammers and sickles on them, right, and stuff like that. Well, there you are.
And what there's a possibility of Nina coming over here for a promotional tour. Did you know that?
And did you know that she's number 17 with a bullet? And if she goes to number one, it'll be one of many number one songs by girls recently. Pat Wilson, Pat Benatar, Cyndi Lauper, and now Nina.
Pat McDonald.
Noina Nonsish.
No, she didn't have any.
Bill Tom? No.
Oh, wait.
Nina, Noina Nonsish.
Is the name of the girl and the group. Hold on for real life, plus news on the Countdown Awards. She's being hailed as the female equivalent to Michael Jackson. From Detroit, USA, the young, bold, and aggressive Madonna with Holiday.
That was Madonna with Holiday. Doesn't look a bit like Michael Jackson. I don't know what Gavin's on about. She's 23 years old, 5'4" tall, and the only girl I know that can lip sync so well with her navel. Hey, Jane.
Yep, this is true. And Real Life, number 59 with a bullet in the US chart, second week in with Catch Me, I'm Falling. And Molly's going to be catching up with them in New York tomorrow.
Is that right?
Yes, and here they are. Real Life, Catch Me, I'm Falling.
Sleep.
From Real Life, who've received three nominations for the Countdown Awards 83 coming up in 3 weeks, Sunday, April 15 at the special time of 5:30 p.m. At last year's awards, Skyhooks blasted off their spectacular reunion tour. This year, you can see Sherbet's Daryl Braithwaite, plus we put the models in motion. Tonight's guest co-host John Paul Young will be there, our special international guest Billy Idol, and the truly amazing Tim and Debbie. The multi-nominated Tim Finn will make your day. There's Jim Keys. Dragon with their special brand of magic will be on the show. Rock Arena's Glenn Shorrock drops in. And Kids in the Kitchen perform their new single. Even Shirley's threatened to turn up, and there's many more surprises. Now for Melbourne viewers only, if you want to be part of the big night, get your tickets from ABC Concerts, 10 Queen Street, Melbourne, phone 600-721. Bookings open 9 tomorrow morning, and tickets are just $5 and $7.50 for the Countdown Awards 83, Sunday, April 15. Still to come, Educational Hall & Oates, plus Countdown Awards special guest, Billy Idol. Now, the band whose motto is, have a good time and be yourself, Huey Lewis in the News, and I want a new drug called love.
My eyes too real.
new song from Huey Lewis and the News. And now here's Molly with more news from Humdrum. At least I got that right.
Mm-hmm. Yes, very rare of you, Gavin. Thank you very much. Listen, with me now, I'm only joking, Gavin. With me, almost a regular now, Russell. Russell Mulcahy, extraordinaire, film director, whatever.
Good to see you again.
Now, listen, you've been really away from the rock industry for
About 14 months.
Yeah. Mm. Well, you've worked with Ivor, who's done the musical score to Razorback.
Ivor's just done an incredible job.
Yeah?
Yeah. I mean, it took a while for us to sort of suss out where we're going to go with the direction of the music, but his music is like modern and also primitive at the same time, and it's just a knockout.
Now, I know you approached Ivor well before you ever thought about, before you ever sort of took any footage whatsoever of the film. Did he go along to any of the shooting just to get an inspirations of what you wanted?
He came along to a few of the scenes, but what I did a rough cut of the film, and then he was basically brought in. Then I showed him a cassette of it.
Right.
He locked himself away with his computers and a monitor and just did it. So and one day he rang me up and said, come over and have a listen to this. Showed me a scene. I said, right. Baby, you got it, you know.
So how many songs is actually on the album then? Do you know?
Oh, well, I guess it's
in the film?
About 14. There's about 14 pieces of music.
Really?
Yeah, a lot of music.
And any vocals at all?
No.
No?
We try to write a song, but it doesn't quite go, does it?
No, right.
Can you think of the lyrics?
No. So the film itself is premiered in Australia on the 18th of April.
Yes.
Right.
Wednesday the 18th.
And the album's
released nationally on the 19th.
And the album's out at the same time.
Yeah.
Actually, it seems to be a lot of that going on, because with using Australian composers now with Australian films, like Billy Field with Undercover.
That's right. And there's also that new one with Street Heroes.
Yeah. So it's good. Good for the... Now, what about Duran Duran? Or should we leave that and do the UK top five first, and then we'll talk about Duran Duran. All right, at number five is Weather Girls. It's Raining Men. My goodness me, they're a bit behind.
Oh, Wool and the Gang, Joanna.
Cool and the Gang, Joanna, number four.
Yeah, who wrote that?
Try three. Break Machine with Street Dance. He's gone hysterical, Russell. What about number two?
Fabulous Nina, 99, Red Balloons.
Who? Been to Germany, haven't
you? Ouch!
Lionel Richie, one of the underrated artists in Australia at the moment, with number one record in England with Hello. As a matter of fact, I love Lionel Richie. I think he's a very fine singer-songwriter. And I cannot understand why radio stations aren't getting behind the follow-up to All Night Long, which is called Running With The Night. So, and I think it should be a hit in this country. Just a
fantastic.
Little bit that I did.
I think you've got to do that. Yeah.
Right. Now, you're going back. Now that you've completed all of that, that's in the can, the feature film. You're going back to what, Duran Duran, you've shot already?
Yeah, we're going to Tokyo to do Lamal, and then straight to San Francisco to do Duran.
Right.
And then come back here for the
premiere. Didn't you shoot some stuff with Duran up in Canada just recently?
Yeah, just in Toronto.
What was that?
A new single called Reflex.
Right.
Fantastic song.
Right. Now, Lamal was the lead singer, of course, of
Kajagoogoo.
Yeah. He's coming out here soon, so you're doing a single for the film for him.
In Tokyo.
Right. And one for Elton, I believe, that starts this week.
Oh, that's right, on Monday. God,
yeah.
Better go.
You're a very busy boy.
Yeah, I mean, that's going to be fun. We've built a really huge set. I mean, like, we tried to find a street and we couldn't find one, so we built it.
And what's it called, the song?
Called Sad Songs.
Sad Songs, is it?
Sad Songs.
Well, while we look at some sad... Well, while we talk about sad songs, let's have a laugh. The Curly Shuffle, is this one of your favourite records?
I love this because I'm a great fan of the Three Stooges. Give me the Three Stooges.
Right, well, there's two versions out at the moment. See if you can pick the difference. The first is by Jumping in the Saddle. The other is the Knuckleheads. The Three Stooges.
We love Larry and Mo. We love Curly's brother Shemp and his fat clone Joe. It's such a delight to boogie and hustle. Dancing all night doing the Curly Shuffle. Hey, Mo, hey, Mo.
Hey, Mo, hey, Mo.
Well, yuck, 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 yuck.
There you go.
Yeah,
it is good, isn't it? The Curly Shuffle. Listen, with MTV, of course, in America, now sort of becoming a very important part of breaking records in America, you being sort of really one of the pioneers of the really big budget rock film clips, what do you think of the standard of today, like for 84?
Yeah, because I've been away from it for a while, and I think what's happening. I mean, the guys doing the clips in Australia are incredible. I mean,
right.
There's some great clips being made in this country.
Right.
But there's been a survey done in MTV. Basically, the audience feel that these days they really want to see bands with preferably instruments in their hands, which is quite an unusual, overreaction to the concept video.
Well, funny enough, and it's not knocking you, but I forget the actual Duran Duran song, but last year, one of the ones that was shot, you know, and had the big storyline mm-hmm. and that, we got another version from Rockline, which was just them sort of on
stage.
It was
more popular.
Yeah, and it's sort of because some people felt that perhaps the groups were sort of
I think the industry's got to settle down and find its own ground.
Right. And you're up for another award, I notice, or actually your film clip, I'm Still Standing. For the best choreographer.
That's right,
In America. I didn't know about it at all. All right, talking about America, here is the US top five. Oh, at number five, here is the Eurythmics. They can't do anything wrong with Here Comes the Rain Again. At number four,
Kenny Loggins and Footloose.
That's a great film. Have you seen it?
Yeah, fantastic.
It's wonderful. Great sound score, too. Cindy, I'll be seeing her in New York next week. Cindy Lauper with Girls Just Want to Have Fun. Great lady.
Rockwell, Somebody's Watching Me. Friend of Michael Jackson's, eh?
So I believe, yes. Mm. Friend of someone else's, too.
Really?
Yes. Van Halen with...
Jump. I do it often.
Yeah, I do too. I'm going to see them in Madison Square Gardens, and we'll have the interview for you in a couple of weeks' time, so watch out for that.
Great.
Well, listen, best of luck with the film.
Thank you very much.
I don't think they'll need any luck. And look forward to seeing you back in the industry making all those film clips.
Yeah, it's fun.
All right, listen, Hall & Oates. Do you like Hall & Oates?
I liked them a lot.
Right. Ever had any adult education? Because I think it's time you did.
Thank you.
So here it is. Hall & Oates with Adult Education. Thanks, Russell.
Thanks,
it's all right, mate.
Host Jane Clifton's coming up with her song soon, but right now, Billy Idol, who'll be here in 3 weeks for the Countdown Awards. This is Rebel Yell.
thousand miles with you. I dried your tears of pain a million times for you, for you, for you. I'd sell my soul for money to burn.
Rebel Yell, and he's going to be the special guest on the Countdown Awards coming up soon. And on Rock Arena on Tuesday, it'll feature an interview with Molly, filmed with Billy Idol in New York live. So something to look forward to on Rock Arena on Tuesday night, and he'll be talking to Molly.
Excuse me, Jane, where's Squeak?
He got bored.
Pardon?
He's gone home.
He's got bored?
Yeah, he got very bored during the last bit when you were talking to that other bloke. He's gone home.
Oh, right. Okay, I thought props might have carted him off.
No, they tried.
No?
Earlier. No.
No, he had to go and catch a plane, didn't he?
I think so.
Oh, well.
He's a working man.
He certainly is. Very busy.
Half his luck.
Half his luck, yes. Listen, there's this lovely lady that I used to adore in a series she doesn't like me talking about anymore.
We don't.
But I quite liked her in this series called Prisoner. But I know that she doesn't want to sort of talk about her acting career because she's a damn good singer.
Oh.
And her name's Jane Clifton, do you know?
No.
Well,
no.
She's the girl on the wall.
The girl.
And here's the single, and it's a great single. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Every time I go to catch a train, an image stares down at me. Oh, every time I buy a magazine, an image stares out at me. So insecure, 'cause I know one thing for sure, that the girl in the mirror ain't the same as the girl on the wall. Baby, it's really turning on.
National charts. As Thriller goes into the Guinness Book of Records for the biggest selling record in history, the title track goes from 8 to 10 on the Countdown chart. The album's seventh single, PYT, Pretty Young Thing, has just been released. Boys Will Be Boys in the Mondo stay at number 9. Look out for a special surprise from the Wilsons at the Countdown Awards. About to go on the road with Eurythmics in the States. Fall up from 18 to 8 with this week's only new top 10 entry. Matthew Wilder throws his second lucky 7 in a row with Break My Stride. There's no stopping the drop as Pat Benatar moves down the line from 3 to 6.
No promises, no defense. Love is a
fluffy. If Frankie did go to Hollywood, he'd probably get an R rating. This week, Relax rates a 5.
Relax, don't do it. When you want a second to it.
Calling Your Name goes from 5 to 4 for the man who once worked as air supplies receptionist in L.A. almost called it quits last year, but instead of splitting up, each went their separate ways for a while and came back to record their biggest hit in 4 years, which moves back to number three this week. Those hot guitar licks on Michael Jackson's Beat It belong to Eddie Van Halen, whose own group are jumping up and down over their newfound chart success. And now it's back to Jane and Molly.
Okay, thanks very much, Gavin, and best of luck, mate. Whatever. No, I know it's awful you sitting in that little box all the time.
Yeah, Gavin? Such a good time, though.
Well, yeah, I don't suffer from claustrophobia, though. I'm okay.
Oh, that's...
You don't have to worry.
No, well, all right. Okay, well, you take care of yourself over the next couple of weeks, won't you?
Same with you.
Now, listen, Jane, as I say, congratulations on the single.
Thank you.
What else are you doing? I mean, I know I wasn't going to ask about acting, but are you going to go sort of vary the roles this year?
Yeah, I've actually got a bit of a part in a real play later this year, in a Shakespearean play, which will happen around about August. But nothing at the moment. I'm just singing jazz at the moment, actually.
Right.
With a little combo.
Now, I asked you before, I believe you saw Renee up in Sydney, because everyone's raving about Renee's thing. Can you just quickly tell them about it?
I actually think it's finished, the show, but it's really fantastic, really great live show.
You girls, very versatile. Talking about versatile girls, do you like Cyndi Lauper?
I did like her.
She was wonderful last week.
Yeah, she was great.
Well, listen, good night. Thanks
good
for
night.
Doing the show.
Thank you.
And it's Good Night Australia, and we go out this week, and I'll see you when you The Big Apple, New York, next week with Cyndi. And girls just want to have fun, and you better believe it.
Number one again this week, and remember, just 3 weeks to the Countdown Awards 83. Good night, Australia, from Gavin Wood.
just reminds me of love.